Hello, in this video I'm going to show you how you can use the MIDI USB library. The MIDI USB library is used to make your Arduino a MIDI class compliant device. However, you can't use it in all Arduinos. This is a library you can use in Arduinos with the microcontroller ATmega32U4. So you can use it in the Arduino Leonardo, Micro, Pro Micro, or any other Arduino that has an ATmega32U4 microcontroller. Okay, so let's get started. In the last class, I showed you how you can use the Arduino IDE, about variables, and some other things that are going to be useful for you in this class. So if you didn't watch it, please go there and watch that class first. Okay, so we are going to use a library. A library is a set of code you're going to add to yours, but it's going to be hidden with several functions, several things that's going to help you to do a task. In this case, to send MIDI over the USB. So there are going to be lots of things under the hood that you don't need to understand in order to use the MIDI USB library. So the first thing we need to do is have in our Arduino. I am using the Arduino Pro Micro, and if you're still in doubt about which Arduino to choose for your MIDI controller, you can watch this video here too, also in the description. And let's plug it in the USB. Okay, so let's come here to Tools and select our board here in Arduino AVR board. You won't find Arduino Pro Micro here. You have to install the SparkFun boards. However, you don't need to use the Arduino Pro Micro here. Remember that I said it has the same microcontroller as the Arduino Leonardo or Micro, so you can just select one of them. So I'm going to choose here Arduino Leonardo, and here import, select your USB port where your Arduino is connected. Okay, so now we need to install a library. I am using the IDE 2.0, and if you're using an older IDE, it's a little bit different, but it's quite similar. You come here to Sketch, Include Library, and there are different ways. You can, if you download the library in a zip file, you can just add zip library and add that zip file, or click in Manage Libraries. Here you can find the libraries that are in the Arduino server. And click here, or type here, MIDI USB. You should find this MIDI USB by Gary Grewal, so install it. Okay, so now there are a couple things we need to do. First, if you install a library, you need to include this library in the beginning of your code. So I'm just going to copy and paste here. So is this include MIDI USB.h. Now, for this specific library, we need to add some things here. So I'm going to add a couple functions. So a function is a chunk of code that do a certain thing. It's a little bit more complex than that, but don't worry. You just need to copy those things here. So I have four functions here. I have this void note on, the note off, control change, and pitch bend. However, if you go deeper and look at the MIDI USB reference guide, you can add different functions to use different things, for example, after touch. But here, I separated the main things that we can use, like note on, note off, and control change, and maybe pitch bend if you also want. But know that after touch, program change, and other things are also possible, but then you need to come here and add those other functions in the way that the library actually wants. Okay, so now how can we use this library to send those MIDI messages? So if I want to send a note on, what I want to do is look in the function that I want to send, that I want to use, let's say note on. So I'm going to type note on, and then parentheses. And then inside the parentheses, we have to see what we have here, which kind of message. So we're going to set the channel, and then the pitch, and then the velocity. So in the MIDI USB library, the channel starts with zero. So in the MIDI world, we have 16 available channels, and they start with zero in the MIDI USB. So from 0 to 15. So I want to send a note in the channel 0, or it's going to be channel 1 in reality. Then I want the pitch, let's say note 36, which is a C, and velocity 127, which is maximum velocity. Here, for example, note 36, it's a C, and I'm going to leave you with a chart with the MIDI notes, with all the notes, so you can know which note is which number is which pitch. Okay, so then I'm going to set a delay of 300 milliseconds. So I'm going to play a note, wait 300 milliseconds, and then I'm going to play the same note, but with velocity zero. So I pressed Command T to adjust the code, just to make it more organized. So this is the same as note of with velocity 127. So I put a comment here. A note on with velocity zero is the same thing as a note off with whatever velocity. But it's a common practice of using velocity zero as a note off. Then I'm going to put another delay. So I'm going to play a note for 300 milliseconds and then stop that note for 300 milliseconds. Let's verify our code, everything working. So I'm going to upload this code now. Okay, so let's go to MIDI monitor and see what's going on. So we have our Arduino Leonardo here, but you see that we're getting a bunch of messages. And let's see here in Ableton, I already opened a piano. So it's definitely not what was supposed to happen. So why is that? This is because there's an extra step we need to do, which is we need to put this MIDI flush after the note we want to send. And if we send a lot of notes, the notes will only be output by the MIDI library after a MIDI flush. So you can set several notes and then only in the end set this flush if you want to output many notes at the same time. But I always recommend putting this flush right after the note you want to send. So I'm going to put this here and here. And let's upload the code again. Okay, so let's come back to MIDI monitor. Now it looks like we are getting the right thing. Let's see here in Ableton. And yeah, we're getting the note for 300 milliseconds on and then 300 milliseconds off. Okay, but let's do something more fun. Let's use the concepts we learned in the last class and learn a new one. So first, what I want to create now is a random MIDI note generator. So let's delete this here. So first, I want to create a variable, which is going to be a byte called rand note. Then in my loop, I want to set rand note to a random note. And here, this random is a function that you can set the minimum. So let's say 30 to 64. So every time in the loop, it will create a new random note between 30 and 64. So let's send a note on in channel 0. The note will be this random note. Velocity 127. Then delay. Let's put 500. Then the same random note, but now note off. So in the beginning of the loop, we will generate a random note. We're going to play this random note on and then the same one off. Next time, we're going to generate a new random note. So let's upload this. Okay, so let's see here in the MIDI monitor. And I forgot the MIDI flush. Okay, let's upload again. Okay, so we are generating some notes. Let's see what's going on here. So we just created a random note generator. Okay, so let's make even more fun. What if we want to select the notes we want to play? For that, I'm going to create a list of numbers, which is also called an array. And the way we use an array is declaring what type of variable will be inside this array. So let's say we're going to use byte. Again, could be integers too. And byte, so let's say notes, or just note. And then we're going to put brackets, and then equal sign, and then between curly braces, we are going to put the notes we want. So let's say 36, 38. So I just created a whole tone scale here. And what we also can do, and sometimes we need to do, is put in here the total number of items we have inside our array. So we have 8 values here. So let's put 8. So now how do we use this array? Here, instead of a random note, I'm going to put note. And inside this note here, I'm going to put the index of the note I want to access. So the index is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So let's say I want to access the note 36. I'm going to put note 0 here, okay? So if I use note 0, I'm going to do this again and just use another note just for you to see. Let's see. Let's use note 1 then. So we should play a C and then a D. So there we have it. But to make it more interesting here, we are going to use this random thing here, okay? So we could do like from 0 to 8. But since we are starting from 0, we don't need the 0 here. We can generate a random number between 0 and 8. And to make it more interesting, let's use a random here from, let's say, 50 milliseconds to 800 milliseconds. So now our delay is also randomized. So let's see what's going on here. We generated a random number between 0 and 8. Here we are going to place a note that is going to be one of these at this index. So if this random note here is 4, we're going to play 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. We're going to play the note 44. Then we're going to delay from a value that's between 50 and 800. And then we are going to play that same note, but with a note off. And then delay again in this random range. Okay? And then next time we're going to have a different random number. So let's see how this sounds. And let's make it a little bit faster. Let's make it the interval shorter. And there you go. Now you know how to use the MIDI USB library, and you also learned how to use arrays and the random function. A good exercise for you now is trying to add a random octave. For example, every time you play a note, you can randomly choose between adding plus 12, plus 24, or minus 12, minus 24. Okay, so I hope you liked it. And if you want to see how this is implemented in the big code with buttons, potentiometers, rotary encoders, LED displays, motorized faders, in a really easy way, in a way that you don't need to code everything yourself, please check my Making Music with Arduino course. The link is here in the description. And there you can also find my free DIY MIDI controller workshop, where I'm going to teach you how to build a MIDI controller with buttons and potentiometers, besides teaching you a lot about the Arduino and much more. Okay, guys, and please put in the comments what kind of thing you'd like to learn next. And subscribe if you didn't do yet to help me out, my friend, okay? So, see you in the next video. Ciao.